And now our third story out front. Mayor Michael Bloomberg and his so-called nanny state. First, he announced a proposal to ban big servings of soda. And now he is taking on baby formula. Starting in September, Bloomberg will implement his Latch On NYC initiative. Why is that a disturbing term? Under this plan, most city hospitals will keep formula out of plain sight to encourage new mothers to breastfeed. Mothers who still want to bottle feed can, but nurses have to sign out the baby formula and explain to them why it's not the best thing to do. Now, this is a quote-unquote voluntary initiative, but so far, two-thirds of New York City hospitals have already latched on to the idea.
Most public health officials want to encourage women to breastfeed at least for the first couple weeks because the outcomes are better. And if they can do it, that's great. And if they can't, they can't. You know, our job is we're not making anybody do it. We're suggesting.
Is this a step too far for the mayor? Out front tonight, Renee Seiler, CEO and founder of GoodEnoughMother.com. We should mention she worked for Evenflow, which is a baby product and supply company. Also out front tonight, Kristen Howerton, a blogger for RageAgainstTheMinivan.com. All right, I love both of your blog names. Let me just say that. Now let's get to it. Renee, does the mayor have a point? I mean, obviously, he right there in the soundbite said, hey, I'm looking at a couple of weeks. But pediatricians do recommend 6 months of breastfeeding. So is he doing the right thing?
I mean, listen, before anybody, you know, says anything, I have to say I'm a big proponent of breastfeeding. I nursed both of my children. I just don't think that this is the way to get that done. I don't think that he says it's a voluntary program, but a woman who's just had a baby and her hormones are all sort of being regulated and she's got this screaming child and she's trying to feed this baby and then you have to call a nurse and ask the nurse for formula. It just seems like so much and then the nurse is going to stand over you and lecture you about...
Right, and if you don't want to do it or it hurts, somehow you're made to feel you are a failure, a bad mother or something like that, right?
Exactly. I feel like this is just one more attack on mothers and on women and I feel like, you know, it's not that women don't want to try. I think most women understand. Most everybody knows that breast is best, unless you've never heard that before, which I'd be shocked by. We know that breastfeeding is good. We know it's best. But like in the case with me and my daughter, it took 3 weeks before we figured it out.
Right. It can take time. Now, Kristen, what about the New York Health Department? They're putting out a lot of numbers out there. One of them, 100% excess risk of inner ear infections, which is one of the things that we hear about can happen very early on in a child's, a baby's life, if they're on formula. But 44% of all infants get that, whether they're ear infections, whether they're breastfed or whether they're not breastfed. So some of these numbers appear to be a little bit scare tactics.
Yeah, you know, it could be, but I do think that this initiative is good in that I think that there is pretty rampant formula pushing happening in American hospitals all across America. I mean, I know when I had my babies, both times I was given a gift bag that had branding of formula all over it. I was offered formula bottles by nurses. So I do think that there's a middle ground here that we should be striving for, where women are encouraged to breastfeed and aren't just offered a bottle of formula to give to their children as soon as a baby's born.
What do you think about